The market for loanable funds is a great market to apply the competitive market model. The supply and demand model works well here because the market meets the major assumptions of competitive model. So let's define the market for loanable funds. First, there are two sides to the market. Savers, those are households or individuals with excess funds. They supply money to the market. On the other side, you have demanders of money, or also referred to as borrowers. The market here exists in any place that assists with connecting savers and borrowers. These markets can be in the form of stock exchanges, investment banks, mutual funds, or commercial banks. These markets will allow savers to provide funds to loan to borrowers. The difference in this market is we are allocating money from one group to the other. And therefore, the question becomes, how do you price this product? Well, the price on money is usually in the form of interest rates. Savers or suppliers of loanable funds are rewarded with a return, usually expressed as an interest rate. That same interest rate is then charged to borrowers as a cost of funds. So this brings us to an important part of this market. Every dollar borrowed requires a dollar saved on the other side of the market. So let's look at this graphically. We can represent this market using the competitive market model. On the y-axis, we have interest rates, and the amount of funds or quantity on the x-axis. Savings is represented by the supply curve, the law of supply holds here. As interest rates increase, savers respond by increasing the quantity supplied of funds. Demand of funds or borrowers, a demander of funds or borrowers have an inverse relationship between interest rates and quantity of loans demanded. As interest rates fall, borrowers increase the quantity of loans demanded. At the intersection, we have an interest rate that creates an equilibrium in this market. All funds saved are lent out to borrowers. At an interest rate higher than that, we would have too much saving and not enough borrowing. At a rate below equilibrium, we would have too many borrowers and not enough savers. This market finds its equilibrium at an interest rate of, in this example, 4% and $250 billion. That's the amount of money that will be exchanged between savers and borrowers. In this video, we use the competitive market model and applied it to the market for loanable funds. The next video will introduce market changes and see how savers and borrowers change their behavior. We will also identify the determinants of savings and the determinants of borrowing so we could understand the market better. See you next class.